I'm James Intriligator. I'm a professor of innovation and consumer psychology at Bangor University. I do research on perception, attention, vision, consumer issues. Yeah, I don't know. How did I end up falling into this role? I started off interested in just the brain. I wanted to understand how it is that the brain works. And so I started off doing computer science, but that didn't quite answer it for me. And so I ended up sort of evolving and slowly wandering from computer science into philosophy and mathematics, and finally ended up in psychology. The work that I do now is primarily in consumer psychology. There have been some huge changes in terms of understanding how people make decisions, how people make shopping choices, things like that. People don't actually use their rational mind to choose products that they buy or to choose which websites they go to, for instance. There are people, myself included, who do some research on brain imaging to try to understand what parts of the brain help us choose different products. We're looking at how the brain responds to different kinds of special offers, things like that. People make decisions based on gut instinct, based on emotional reactions. I'm the worst. I spend hours in supermarkets and I get pulled in by every kind of display that's there. And I'm just intrigued to understand how different special offers are appealing to different kinds of people. The way consumer psychology is studied in different countries is actually quite interesting. The way that we approach it here in the UK, within Bangor in particular, is we try to understand the psychological processes that underlie decision-making, emotion, motivation, things like that. So it's not just what do people do, but it's more about why do they do what they do. The ability to actually work with real companies on real projects, I think, is something unique to the UK in a sense. Class sizes are so small that it's actually possible for us to get our students to work with a range of local companies. I suppose one thing that's quite surprising is how tiny differences in the way something is explained, displayed, small environmental differences can have huge impacts on people's behavior. Understanding how to get people to use hospitals, use healthcare services, in terms of how people spend money, a lot of that is actually dictated by government. For them to understand how consumers behave is really vital as well. So we've been looking at things like how the smell in a room will have people shop differently, or how a sign in the corner of a room will make people behave differently. All of those things can actually have huge impacts, and I think that area is quite fascinating all around. It's a great area to study just because of how it can be applied in so many different fields. We actually are just about to release a game that helps people stop drinking. And you play this little game and it sort of plays with your mind, plays with your visual attention, and retrains your brain in a way to make you stop paying so much attention to alcohol. We have lab data suggesting that that will help you stop drinking. All these kinds of gamification techniques are really quite powerful for behavior change. You either want to get people to buy more of something or to consume less of something. All of that is part of consumer psychology. So I think for any of those areas, whether it's, you know, selling things to people or helping people to stop drinking, smoking, all that kind of stuff, you know, it's a great background for all of those different areas.